Well, my name is John McCarthy. I'm very normally mad. I'm mad and I'm proud.
Do you ever just think, you know, God, I wonder if, or maybe, and you let it go?
It's like you're shipwrecked at sea. You're all on a little piece of wood and you're hanging on to a piece of wood and you're trying to keep afloat, you know, and you want to help everybody else around you, but you know if you let go of your wood, you're going to sink down a little bit lower yourself. So it's tough. It's very, very tough.
And it just kept coming back, the idea of if there was a program for people who, you know, where death was genuinely an option, but if there was a program that looked at the possibility of life.
I saw their initial advertisement was in the health section of the Cork Examiner asking for awardees to apply.
It was about 2 weeks before the application deadline, so I rang it up, downloaded the application, and basically spent the next 2 weeks applying for the thing. And like, so I got the level one awardee last year, and then we'd obviously impressed them enough that this year they gave us the level two award.
One of the reasons that I was particularly interested in aligning myself with SEI was because I feel that I need the mentorship, basically, to move from an NGO background of some 30 years into something more like a business.
I mean, there's a small amount of financial support for level ones like us. That's not hugely significant in the scale of things. But the fact that we're part of a network and that there is the common spirit, the fact that we have a wide diversity of projects, but all with this idea that we can, you know, do good in our community and improve the lot of the people we're trying to serve. That's quite inspirational. That's very motivational to be with them.
That's the uniqueness of SEI. They accept your worth. They accept your worth. They take the risk. It may fail. I may fail. I may not do what I'm telling them I'm going to do. But that's the risk. And if I do fail, I would feel confident enough to come back to SEI and say to them, I screwed up. I need to start it again. I need to do it in a different way. I need to tweak it. I need to do whatever.
I didn't know a whole lot about social enterprise, and I didn't know I was a social entrepreneur. And I thought, that's just me. But I went in and most of the others were the same. They were doing what they were doing without knowing they were social entrepreneurs.
I learned a lot from other people. You know, you talk about a small problem and then we're giving each other tips and ideas, and we're actually getting to know more about each other's projects.
So it's just the sharing of knowledge. And I suppose the synergy when a group of people like that come together is quite amazing.
If you engage and if you talk to all the people, and then I remember during the year I'd see a flash of someone's face, so you can go onto the SEI website, look at the photographs, that's why they're so good. Look at the photographs, that's who they were, so you can just contact them.
There's just something about being with good company and being with people that have share the same sort of values and the same vision for the world. You just get totally inspired by it, and you almost take energy from them, and hopefully they're taking energy from you. Just to go on and do more.
It's about entrepreneurship. This is a business. This is a business without profit, as in financial terms. This is a business with the greatest profit in the world spiritually. Just can't quantify it. It's up to yourselves.
We're going to go into looking at some cultural practices and getting really children to look at a broader picture and challenge negative stereotypes.
It is a support group set up for bereaved parents by bereaved parents. And I suppose why we do this is to try and, break the isolation that often follows after the loss of a child for bereaved parents, and maybe just create a little bit of understanding what they're going through. And
we developed what is a social franchise. A facility just like Spar or McDonald's, where we do everything for the operator. We have everything they need except childcare, and they are early years educators. So they do that, we do our bit, and the thing works.
Do you know nobody ever sat down and said, what do you think, Caroline, might help you? Nobody asked me to be involved in my own recovery program until much, much later. You see, I didn't change. The core of who I was always was. I didn't change. But that's where the idea of SOS was true. Listen to people and listen to what they're not saying.
It's all about social integration, social inclusion. It's all about integration. It's all about employment. It's fundamentally a way of people helping themselves socially and economically.
If you come on the program, we'll give our part, but you need to give your part as well, because you're not broken and I'm not going to fix you. But what we're going to do is remember what you are capable of.
So we run leadership training programs in schools, youth organizations, youth clubs, and then week-long international programs for young people from all over the world. Just to really connect with them and sit down with them and say, you know what, you can actually make a difference in the world, and help them build the confidence to do that.
And there's 30 members of that. There's 4 of them gone back into full-time employment. I would suggest that we saved 3 people's lives because we simply went out in the middle of the night and sat down with them.
They believe in you. Do you know what it's like when someone believes in you? It's like, God.
They're focused, they're human, they're supportive, they go the extra mile.
Opens doors in terms of what you call yourself, but it also opens doors that if you do ring the office and you do need an introduction to someone or you're looking for mentoring, there is somebody at the end of the phone who believes in you and believes in your project.
It has connections everywhere. Everywhere.
You know, they're thinking about all of us. They're thinking about us in specifics.
They're creating an environment where people learn from each other, where people are encouraged, where they're supported.
It's a fantastic octopus.
We can't do without them, because 2 heads, they say, is always better than 1, no matter how efficient that 1 head is.
They are unchanging in their belief of you, no matter what moment, if you ring them in a good moment or ring them in a bad moment.
But with social entrepreneurs developing me, developing the organisation, I mean, we're going to get there faster, and we need to get there faster, because every day, you know, a child or a son or daughter is killed on the roads in Ireland, or a child dies in a hospital, or somebody dies in a hospice, you know, that's somebody's son or daughter. So we need to be there, we need to be established.
They care. You see, they actually care.
I would be worried for social entrepreneurs in other countries that don't have that level of support. It would be hard to do it without them.
They're going to get the best performers in here. They're going to get the best performers, the creme de la creme. Because the people that are going to come in here are the risk takers. The people that are going to come in here are the true entrepreneurs. Because they don't need the comfort of the structure. Because they're going to do it themselves. They're going to get off their arse and do it themselves. And that's what it's about.
What's jumping up is magic. Magic.
Brilliant.
Inspirational.
Magic. They are magic.
Love. What would you mean?
I believe in you. It's powerful, isn't it?